then she said, oh, you are involved in the medicine, and she knows these medical benefits and so on. So she asked me to spread this knowledge too, okay? So it's a very original version. The Bumbhajan, there are many different versions, you know. I think some of them, there are some, how do you say, there are some wrong teachings about Bumbhajan. Some Bumbhajan says you are empty stomach and this, there are many explanations, but this is the four steps. Inhalation, Mukh Gang. Second one is to build your vase, make your vase come up a little bit. And then third is churning. So inhalation, feeling, churning, and exhalation. It's called the four points of Bumbhajan, Vaz Yoga. For Murtam, Gantam, Jilvatam, Datar Pantam, Mambashi. Inhalation, feeling, churning, and exhalation. Exhalation like a shooting arrow. Okay? Murtam, Murtam, Gantam, Jilvatam, Datar Pantam, Mambashi, Mambashi, Sarahai, Chechui. From Saraha. Okay? Right? I told you this exercise is very important for rejuvenation and for prolong our life, right? Do you remember the story of Nagarjuna? Nagarjuna was a little boy, he was very weak and very sick, and because of this Bumbhajan he prolonged his life. He became almost immortal. And then there is another very interesting story, one very famous Tibetan lady master who was called the Serakhandro. You can read her autobiography, it's called Love and Liberation, the book. Yeah? Love and Liberation. You read her book. You know, she was the one of the most famous lady master in Tibet in the beginning of last century. And when she was, I think, 7 or 8 years old, she had a dream. And in her dream, she met an Indian yogi. You know, this yogi is called the Kukuripa. Means the dog yogi. The dog yogi. Because they said he looks like a dog. He has many hair, you know. And then this yogi taught her some special yoga. So next day she wakes up, she remembers very well. And she did it and she really liked it. So that yoga made her very happy. And this yoga helped her, you know, keep focus. She was very kind of very stable mind and very strong spiritually, you know. And this, and yeah, then when she was 15 years old, her father did arrange marriage for her, you know. She was born in a rich family and her father said, you have to marry another rich family's guy, you know. He did the family arrange the marriage, but she escaped that marriage. Because her spiritual, how do you say, dream was so powerful, and then she did her meditation and she did everything, right? So that dream was very funny. That dream, she received the Bumbhajan. This yogi taught her Bumbhajan in the beginning, and he said, you only do this practice, okay? So it's also very interesting, you know, about Bumbhajan give us energy, but also it gives us the courage, you know? The strings, mental strings and mental courage. Alright? So she did it, and then I think after a few years she dreamed him again, and then he gave her more yogic exercises. Alright? So later, and when she was 20 years old, and then she had a special dream, when she woke up from that dream, she knew how to read and write. Before that, she didn't know, you know, she was never trained, she never studied. She was very much in spiritual and yoga, meditation, these things, but she never studied. But because of one special dream, when she woke up and she knew how to write and read, and then she wrote 13 or 14 volumes of books. 13 books. Mm-hmm. Okay? They're very poetic and the grammar is perfect. It's really amazing, you know. You can't imagine, how do you say, unliterated girl, she wrote so many books in a perfect way, okay? But why I'm telling her story, because also her potential, her capacity is connected with Gumbhajan. Okay? She received this teaching from Dren. Alright? So that's why I think it's very good to do this Gumbhajan every day, at least 21 times. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's about Gumbhajan. Any other questions?